And here is the one to demonstrate any wastewater treatment plant has any effect. So they are from the downstream and upstream to look at the information. And they found that this is the municipal waste plant. And this is the industry site. It's a very, very high exposure of the PFOS, you can see it here. And we can find that it's a very downstream, the waste, wastewater, the influent discharge. It's very high exposure. And then they want to look at the aquatic environment and the very high exposure of the PFOS. This is a tilapia, and the catfish. The mussel is only 1,400 at here from the Kaya River. This is a Taipei River, is not so high. And here's the liver tissue. It's very, very high. So don't eat the liver of the fish. Okay, and this is our previous study. We found that the PFNA is negative associate, and then PFOS is a positive associate with the insulin resistance. And in the adult also, the picture of the PFNA is reduced, and the insulin resistance, and the PFOS increased the insulin resistance. Now this is one study we demonstrate that the adiponectin associated with the PFNA. So that is PFNA play as the role of the adiponectin, the PPA gamma, so they increase the adiponectin. We also showing that the PFOS and PFNA the interaction upon the odds ratio of the thicker IMT. So that is PFOS is higher and the PFNA is low, and the risk of the subclinical atherosclerosis will increase. So here we found that the PFOS associated with the IMT, associated with the LDL levels, and associated with the uric acid. And this is after multiple variety controlling, and we found that the PFOS increased with the CRMT, and the PFNA is negative associated with the CRMT. And the recent study, we found that in another adult cohort, we're trying to demonstrate in 571 middle-aged population and to look at the risk of diabetes. So we are using the OGTT. Everybody have to receive the standard OGTT study. And we found the glucose area under curve and HbA1c and the diabetes risk. So in different kind of the timing, the higher level of PFOS will increase the level of the glucose level, and the PFNA is negative. It's negative. So the risk of the PFOS at here is 3.37, and here is increase the risk of 2.39 for every doubling increase PFOS exposure. And lastly, I was showing that the CRMT levels and the endothelial microparticle and the PFOS exposure. We found the PFOS exposure will increase for the endothelial microparticle. And we look at the plaque microparticle also increased in PFOS levels. And the CRMT label is the similar picture. And here we are combine different factors. The higher level of the plaque microparticle and the higher level of the PFOS and the CRMT risk were higher. And here is the both the endothelial microparticle and the plaque microparticle increase. And the higher PFOS will increase the risk of the thicker IMT. So here is the demonstration here. Endothelial microparticle and the plaque microparticle increase, and diabetes and glucose levels, and the CRMT. So the risk of coronary heart disease should be suspected. So this is a proposed mechanism of the PFCS and the health. From here, PFOS increase the endothelial dysfunction and the oxidation stress, and the CRMT and the DM increase. The PFNA is a protective effect, increase the PPAR gamma and the adiponectin levels, and they will reduce the CRMT and the risk of diabetes. So we have the conclusion that plasticizer and the PFCS are common pollutants around us. The diabetogenic and atherogenic potentials of the DEHP and the PFOS was demonstrated in our series of study. How to prevent exposure to DHP and PFOS in our daily life and dietary habits are very important for the primary prevention of diabetes and cardiovascular disease. So this is in Chinese, you know, it's a disease. And you know, the inner side of the world is the one, we say in Chinese is one, is from the east to north, from east to west. It is the food in Chinese. And this is the door, and this is a human, and this is the intake. So it means if you eat a contaminated food, or you inhale the bad air, you get the disease. So that is very interesting. Thank you very much.
CFAM, caring for well-being.